Yo, so I've been working on this map like all Christmas break. Halo Infinite, they released Forge, and I didn't really care about it much, you know. It was like, whatever, I can maybe download new maps that people have been making and stuff. I got around toying around with it around Thursday after work. Just the skybox and stuff, and all of a sudden it just drew me in. So I started developing a map, and I wanted this map to be like a campaign map, a cooperative two-player campaign map. I hear there's a rumor that they may release AI for the Covenant into Forge. So I don't know much about Forge when it comes to Halo 5 and Halo Infinite, you know, with scripting and everything. I did my best at it, and this project wasn't just straight out of my mind. I wanted it to be representative or inspired by Halo HeadHunters, the animated short story. Me and my best friend really adore that story, and we think it's badass, so I wanted to make it into a playable mission, and I've always wanted this, you know, so finally I came around doing it with bots and stuff, so yeah. Here are the steps. I made this mission because I couldn't make this mission exactly just what the cinematic was, the short. So let's go dive into it. Did the best I could. So first you got the pelican drop. After that, you got the first jungle walk. And then you go to a clearing where there's water. After that, you have the next jungle walk where it's concealed, where, you know, you can barely look through the canopy or the forest. After that, you have your first encounter when you get into that forest. And the first encounter is supposed to be grunts, you know. Now, I'm thinking about putting an elite, but of course there are bots in there. So, after that first encounter, you go up a hill, and you'll do the higher jungle walk, which is a log, you know, a plank, and they have, like, a lot of steam coming out of it. Then you come up to the snipers, where Roll and Jay are in the brush, so I have that brush there, you know. Now, they're supposed to plant bombs there, which I want to put that in there later, you know, with scripting and whatnot. Then after that, you go up to the actual cliff. Now, the cliff scene's really cool. That's where, you know, the guns are. And you can notice them on the cliff. They're separate. Jay is looking down at the enemy, and Roll is there cleaning his weapon over by the rock. You'll notice when I'm playing, I have a sniper rifle and grenades by the rock. Then I have, over by Jay, by the cliff, where you can see the Covenant stuff, a shotgun, and I forgot what they're called, but they're practically electric grenades, you know? So they're like the stuns grenades that he has. So you're supposed to, how it's supposed to play, one person is supposed to go left inside of the facility to fight the Covenant, which is Jay's role. Then the other person, who's playing his role, who's supposed to take the sniper, they go over to the right side to plant all the bombs on all the fusion coil, or the whatever you want to call them, you know, the silos. So, and then at the end of it, you're supposed to meet up behind the base at the door and group up and fight. Roll's flanking, Jay's taking up the head, pretty much. But in this walkthrough, just this example, just to show you guys, I went to the sniper side first. I went right first, if I was playing as Roll. And I put the sniper and shotgun there, just to, you know, it's not going to be exactly like, you know, the story. I wanted to add some fun. I didn't even think about putting hunters in back. Anyway, so I went there, blah blah, ran back over by Jay's entrance after I was done looking around because this bot spooked me. Went over by Jay's entrance, went inside, fought all the Covenant like you're supposed to. and then came outside of the door, the back door, and that's where he's supposed to meet up with Rolf, the other player, and he'll snipe away while you fight the Covenant.
Slayer.
Out to seize the enemy. Deftly employed. The right tool for the job.
Double kill. Triple kill. killing spree. Frenzy. Double kill.
Sidearm, deftly employed. The right tool for the job.
Time for a little payback.
Triple kill. Overkill.
Unbridled and intense personification.
Killing spree.
And adoration.
Kill. Killing frenzy.
City.
All right, so there is my Halo campaign mission based off of Headhunters. Now, there's so much more I want to do with it, but like I said, I've been working this 4 days, and my knowledge of Forge is very limited. So this is all I could really come up with until they come out with the AI for the Covenant. I'm excited for that, but this makes me want to work on other PvE elements, since Halo Infinite really has no content for PvE fans, you know, besides the campaign and stuff. But I just watching this, just playing with it, just inspired me and just made me realize people who know how to do this, unlike me, but this is all I got to make and this is okay. At least for me, it's okay. But the people know what they're doing, dude. Oh man, it's gonna 3 for 3 doesn't even need to release content then, because we'll get it all here from the fans and the Forgers community. Of course, I want it to be tied. I want challenges to be tied for. I want PvE challenges as well and all that good stuff. But yeah, that was my mission. And yeah, I will catch you folks later. Rock on, Renegade, and be yourself. Peace!